Good morning, dear students. How are you all? Hope you're doing good. In the previous class, we have seen the poem Dad and the Cat and the Tree, written by Kit Wright. And there in the poem, we have learned that how Dad tried to bring or protect the cat from a tree because the cat got stuck up on the tree. Isn't it? All the unsuccessful ways of bringing the cat down has finally become successful, but it is not completely successful, but anyhow the cat, he himself got down the tree, isn't it? So in this new lesson, this is lesson number 8. The title of the lesson is Fire, Friend and Foe. Fire can be dangerous because it hurts people, it hurts the things, it hurts animals, it hurts even the big forests. Because usually during the childhood days, we teach the children not to go near the fire. Because suppose if they touch the fire, they get burns. That's the reason we elders never keep the things, the sharp things, medicines and fire and all other dangerous things near the child, isn't it? Fire causes a great harm. At the same time, we have got many uses out of fire. In this lesson, Fire, Friend and Foe, we will learn a few facts regarding fire. Let me go through page number, 114. All of you are requested to open up your textbooks and take the page number 114. Before we get to learn the things from the lesson Fire, Friend and Foe, just go through a few things regarding fire. Fire is both useful and dangerous. What is fire? How did we discover it? And how do we control it? Okay, what's the fire? How did we discover the fire? And how do we control it? Okay, let us move through. Early man did not know what fire was, but he must have seen the damage it could cause. The early man. So when the history of man starts, or when the life of a man starts on the globe or on the earth, actually he doesn't know, he didn't discover first of all, actually he could see the damage that it causes. He must have watched lightning and volcanoes long before he began to use fire himself. Before he started using the fire for a good thing or for a good cause, he might have seen the eruption of volcanoes as well as the lightning. These two are the most dangerous things that would occur by nature. Naturally, it causes. Okay? And accidentally also fire can cause a great damage that we will see. Fire was powerful and dangerous and he was frightened. The fire is personified here. It can also be frightening. Whenever you see the damage caused by the fire, you would be really, feel that, oh, it causes a great damage and you get frightened also. Fire was very, very powerful. At the same time, it's too dangerous too. Fire may have puzzled every man, but we now know that fire is the result of a chemical reaction. The fire that we can see is not just a physical activity. It is constitutes a chemical reaction also. Due to chemical reaction, the fire can happen, the fire can be occurred. When the oxygen in the air combines with carbon and hydrogen in a fuel. See, in order to make fire, we need to have fuel. Fuel is nothing but the matter which can make the fire actually. Fuel can be liquidized and sometimes a solid also. The solidified fuel can be coal, you can say. It's not completely solid, it's a semi-solid type, and we can consider it as a solid. And fuels can be petrol, kerosene and also diesel, etc., etc. These are all liquidized fuels. And fuels can also be solids like wood. Wood is a solid fuel. So when you in order to use for making a fire, isn't it? Actually, fire can cause this because of the combination of oxygen, hydrogen and carbon. Okay, all three gases can form to get the fire. It's a chemical reaction takes place. Energy in the form of heat and light is released in this process. Whenever you just wanted to make fire, what are the two important things that you can see? Heat energy is liberated and the light energy. Along with heat energy, light is also extinguished, or the light is also can be seen out. The light is also can be produced during the process of releasing the fire. This is what we call fire. So fire can be made very easily with the help of fuel. And wherever or whichever the fuel that you use in order to make the fire, what is very, very important? You need to make the heat. Unless you make heat, you cannot make the fire. So whenever fire is occurred, fire is happened, two different things that they can be liberated or released. What are those? Heat energy and light energy. These two energies are different forms of energy. Understand? Three things are needed to make fire: fuel, oxygen and heat, wood, coal, cooking gas and petrol, or some examples of fuel. What are the different kinds of examples for fuel? It's given there: wood, coal and cooking gas. Even gaseous gas is also very important for making fire, wood as well as the coal. Oxygen comes from the air. How can we get oxygen? Through air we can get oxygen. That is why when you blow on smoldering paper, it often bursts into flame. There is a kind of paper called smoldering paper. It is burning slowly without flame. What is smoldering paper? It's burning slowly without flame. Especially nowadays we are using fast cars in order to drive out all the mosquitoes out from our home. That is nothing but smoldering paper. Okay, the very first or the beginning state, it can give a little fire, but slowly it starts burning. The paper get burnt, so the medicine or the chemical which is there within the paper when it is being produced is liberated out through the air, so that the mosquitoes will die. Smoldering paper. So I think you can understand this point very easily if I give the example of flashcards, and fast cards, not flashcards, fast cards, because I never use it much, but I heard it. So when you blow on smoldering paper, it often bursts into flame. It bursts into flame. The third thing needed to make fire is heat. Oxygen is required. Next thing is heat is required. Heat is produced when you start burning the fuel. Fuel and oxygen do not make fire by themselves. Unless heat energy, even the fuel and oxygen also cannot be helpful in order to make fire. Okay, even fuel and oxygen, they themselves cannot make fire. Or else a newspaper or a stick lying in the open wood catch fire on its own. What is that? A newspaper or stick lying in the open would catch the fire on its own. Sometimes the papers and the sticks, especially how does the forest can get fire, because of that? Because of that thing only. Because in the forest we can see all the woods, all the plants and big trees, are located much closer. So because of the blowing wind, these trees trunks would be get roughage, and because of that the fire can be produced. So to burn a piece of paper or wood, we heat it before it catches fire. What is very, very important? The fuel must be heated. Unless you heat the fuel cannot catch the fire, or it will not burn. Why? Simply oxygen and the fuel doesn't work out. What is also required? Heat energy is also required. Unless you heat up the newspaper, unless you heat up the wood, it cannot catch the fire. Understand? You got the fuel, you got the wood, but if you are not producing any heat on the fuel will not make the fire. So we generally do it with a lighted match. So what we'll be using? Lighted match we'll use in order to make fire. Every fuel has a particular temperature at which it begins to burn. This temperature is called the flash point or a kindling temperature of the fuel. Every single fuel, there are different kinds of fuels, okay, existing in the world. But any fuel can be burnt completely and this at one particular temperature. The temperature is called flash point or kindling point, kindling temperature. At which temperature, okay? At which point of the temperature the fuel is catching the fire, that particular point is called flash point or kindling point. In order to kindle the fire, okay, the firewood or the fuel needs to have or needs to maintain one point, one temperature point. That temperature point is nothing but kindling point or the flash point. Understand? It is sometimes said that fire is a good servant but a bad master. That's why, what do we call it? In order to make fire, in order to kindle the fire, we need to have some heat energy. So that's why we will give one title to this fire. Fire is a good servant but a bad master. Sometimes it serves in a good sense and sometimes it causes a great damage in large scale. That's why there is one quotation given it to fire. Fire is a good servant but a bad master. It only means that fire is very useful as long as it is kept under control. So always we have to bear it in our mind that, okay, this fire must be maintained properly. This fire must be kept under good control. Once the control is lost, what happens? It causes a great damage. So we all must be very, very careful. Today we have learned, okay, not only fuel, okay, not only just fuel and oxygen is required to make fire. Heat energy is also required. That heat energy maintained by any fuel at one particular point of the temperature is called, okay, flash point or kindling temperature. Understand, children? Let us come to the next. For instance, we use it to cook food. Without fire, we cannot make food. We cannot cook food. And warm our homes. Okay, during the winter season, almost in all Western countries, the people will have heaters. Okay, electrified heaters. So those heaters also will work with the help of this fire only. Okay, for instance, we use it to cook food for food. Our houses can be warmed up during winter and generate electricity. But on the other hand, if fire gets out of control, it can be very dangerous. That's why we say that fire is a good servant but a bad master. So we should learn this fact. On the other hand, if fire gets out of control, it can be very dangerous. If it gets out of control, it can be a very dangerous thing. Each year, thousands of homes and shops are damaged by fire during the time of Diwali. So Diwali is approaching, no? You should be very, very careful with the fire. Usually children would like to play with the fire. As I said to you, unless you keep it in under control, it will cause a great damage. Sometimes that damage cannot be regained, okay? You cannot bring back to the proper state. Okay, sometimes the people are losing their organs of the body too. So if the fire accidents are severe. So fire accidents are mostly very, very severe. And at the same time, we should be very careful. Unless we take care of it, it will cause a great damage. Mostly, the areas, the small little factories where this fireworks are being produced or being made, there the fire accidents are very, very common. Okay, fire accidents are very common at the places like wherever this industries, small scale industries, are located where they are not taking any precautionary steps in order to make these fireworks. Okay, the industries where the fireworks are generated or produced, there we can see or get the news of the fire accidents. Vast areas of forests are also destroyed. As I told you, especially in Australia, the big vast areas of forest is get burnt. Why, you know, because of this fire accidents only. The thick forests are usually get burnt, and also they are completely get destroyed, and hundreds of people are killed or injured. We happen to hear that the people are killed in a large scale, and also as well as animals recently. When it had happened, you please give me the news in the next class. And most of them are injured. And all the wild species of the animals in Australia were washed out. Why, you know? Why, you know? Because of this forest fires. So what you have to know about it? What are the recent fire accidents at different places in India? You please get the news about. Okay, it will keep you in touch, and it will also will make you understand or to know the current affairs, isn't it? Knowing the current affairs and following what's happening around us is very important, because we are the citizens of India and we are the citizens of this earth, and this is our duty to know about the things, especially when we are learning about something. And fire is a very good servant but a bad master, I told you. And just as three things are needed to start a fire, what are the three things that are needed? Fuel is required, oxygen is required, and also the heat energy or the light energy is required. Unless you heat the fuel will not catch the fire. Okay, if you wanted to make fire, the three things are very important. There are three main ways in which a fire can be put out. Okay, fire is made. How we can put out the fire? Some people say that when we use water, the fire will get more. The blazes of fire will get more. So using water in order to put out the fires is a wrong idea. What is the next thing? Sometimes we need to use sand. What we need to use in order to put out the fire? Sand is required. You need to use the sand in order to put off the fire. In each one of the three things needed for burning is taken away. Okay, three things are there now. Among these three things, one of the things must be taken away so that you can easily put off the fire or put out the fire. Put off or put out the fire, both of them can be used. These are the phrasal verbs. Okay, put out. And for example, we can take away the fuel. If you really wanted to stop the fire, what you need to do? Stop the fuel. Okay? Suppose if this fire is occurred because of gas, what you have to do? You have to remove the gas away from it. Suppose it is happening because of the oxygen. If the fire has no fuel to feed on, no burning can take place, we often let a fire die out simply by not adding more fuel to it. If you wanted to put off the fire, what you have to do? You have to die out the fuel. Fuel should be get away from the fire. So when you take away the fuel from the fire will die out. Simply we can die out the fire so that you can be away from danger. And there are actually too many ways how we can put out the fire is given in coming, further paragraphs. And this information and little more information can be added to this lesson in the next class. Until then, goodbye children. And you are requested to read the lesson and answer the questions which I'm gonna give it to you. Until we meet again, goodbye, take care.